Welcome to the workshop, gardeners. Today I'm going to be decorating our lamppost. And to be honest with you, this is the first year I've done it. And the inspiration really comes from this book that I got last year at Christmas time. I'm going to insert a picture here. It's from Colonial Williamsburg at Christmas. And I saw this lamppost right on the cover. And right away I knew, well, I thought to myself first, why haven't I ever decorated my lamppost? So sometimes we just need little bits of inspiration like that to come up with a new idea. Now, here's the thing though. I've never constructed one of these, so you're just gonna kind of have to hang out and see how it turns out.
Okay, let me zoom in here. Okay, so there it is. What my plan is to put the little scarf right, almost like if you were to picture the lamppost, if this was the head and this is the neck, you're just putting it right underneath that light. And so if you can see, there's kind of like an indentation where it does cinch in right there. And so that's where I'm gonna try to like kind of, if you were to tie it tight, and then hopefully it will be secure for this season.
The idea behind this is I'm gonna be making, like, if you will, two sides, and then the idea is kind of to sandwich these two teardrops together. Now in the picture, in the inspiration picture, the greens are kind of poking out at the top. And so if you can imagine the lamppost head, let's just call it right here, and then these smaller, shorter greens kind of at the top. That's why I have mentioned in past videos, it's nice to have different sizes for this very reason. And then the bottom, and again, I have two separate bundles here, will be longer bottom. So here's like the rough construction, if you can kind of picture it, okay? And then now total confession here, but no bow shaming. I'm not a bow maker. Even when I worked at the garden center and we would construct thousands of wreaths, I just put the pine cones on most of the day to avoid making the bows. So this is kind of my bow, but once it's up there, it'll look cute. So let's just go with that. So I hope, let me kind of lay it down so you can kind of see what we're going to be working with here. And then I'm going to be adding some more adornments, but, and then there'll be two of these again. Now the thing I thought about last night is how am I gonna tie these on there? So I think I'm gonna be using zip ties. Another thing I'm gonna do quick while I'm just out here is I'm gonna wire these magnolia leaves that fell off when I was doing a different project. So again, I just like to divvy up things evenly since this is gonna be like a twofer here. I'm gonna need two sides again. So these magnolia leaves aren't looking that great, but again, it's gonna be one of these things where it's kind of, I don't wanna say it's far away or whatever, but you won't be able to see the imperfections if we can just kind of go along with that theory.
And you wanna try to get these things pretty darn tight. There's gonna be a lot of wind, and one day when you wake up after a windstorm or something and you see half of it like hanging, you're not gonna wanna go back out there and get out the ladder. Here's just a little bit of magnolia leaves. I think that's cute. It's a little bit of color. I love this color. And also, these are the materials I used in some box planters that will be visible all kind of together, if you will. They're all in one sight line. And so I like to repeat the materials for me. I just find that it's kind of more of a cohesive look. It looks like, you know, like all of it kind of goes together, kind of matchy-matchy, which I like at this time of year. So, okay, so here's the next little bundle. Again, you can see some of these leaves were past their prime or whatever, maybe what that's why they fell off, but okay, so there we go. I got that wire and I'm pulling on them. I'm doing like a little test, like I said, down here while we're not up on the ladder. So now we have two bows
two little clumps of magnolia. And then I had two twisty sugared berries left from a different project. And again, I think that'll just lend nicely to have more of like a cohesive look. Again, here we are. Let's see here. Where were we? Oh, yeah. Okay. So we have three and three. These are the little bunches, kind of like a scarf or a turtleneck, that are going to like brush up against the top of that lantern. So I'm going to lay those down. And then we have, and when I picked out these pieces, I tried to get pieces that just kind of matched. So like these two pieces look similar to me. And then these two pieces looked similar to me. So once you're doing like these kind of like side by side, you want them to look kind of uniform. Okay, so we have that piece. And then I thought I would bulk it out a little bit more. Here's this extra kind of long piece. I'm going to put this one. Yeah, I'll put this one on top. And again, in my mind, it's kind of, I have no idea really what this is going to. Sometimes you just have to try and see what happens. And if it, you're kind of, let's, you know, start over. So I'll try to show that in the video if that happens. So then again, these are going to be up top. And again, I'll have to do some trimming on the branches, which is fine. But I also want to leave some spaces for the bows and all this and that. So right here is kind of like the pinch point where I'm thinking that where I showed you on the lantern, where hopefully I'm going to be able to kind of like pinch it down and that will secure it to the lamppost. So let's just put this on here. Uh-oh, I just lost them. Let's go get them. In here, I'm going to have to kind of change. They're a little bit long. But we definitely need some overlap for a little zip tie action. So as you can see, that doesn't look like much. You'd think, oh my gosh, that's going to look horrible. But don't judge your projects until you get them up there. You'd be surprised how things come together. So then I was thinking of the magnolia. I think what I'm going to do, what I'm going to do is this. I'm going to treat those wires as something for the zip tie to hold on to. Let's see here. Again, this is real. This is how it goes here. Especially when you do a project for the first time and you've never done it, and then you decide to video it, you're like, what? What am I thinking? Okay, so then let's put that down here. So I think I'm going to get a zip tie on one of these. These zip ties, you want to get as tight as you possibly can. You don't want any of these. You almost want to pull a little bit on all the branches. Literally get it as tight as you can and do a little test. Go like this. That's happened to me before where you go out there and there's like something hanging or on the ground. Here once. I'm kind of getting the shape I want. Now let me show you this way. Just cut one of these little things off. Now you don't want to cut these branches too short. This is where the bow is going to go, so it's going to hide some of that. You don't want to, you have enough that it's not going to fall through. Oh, see, I got a couple more clicks on that. On that zip tie. Now, don't get this one. I like to, whenever I'm doing twosie projects, like if I need things to match, I do them together. If you do one and then try to do the next one separately, I just feel like you don't get the same look. This way you get almost like a twin. I hope that makes sense. Okay, again, get those. Give it the shake.
To imagine, it's hard to kind of show this in a horizontal view. Now let me try to pull it back as much as I can.
Okay, so can we see this? This is like coming together on the lamppost. Like they might need a tad more bulkier at the bottom. Okay,
that's looking pretty substantial. It's looking nice.
Okay, so now let's do a fake bow. Where did my bows go? Okay, here they are. And I'll fix these little, like I said, no bow shaming here on my channel. Okay, so look at that. Doesn't that just add so much? I love it. Okay, so far, so good. I'm happy with what we got here. Now, I just used a little pipe cleaner to attach. So now's the time. Again, make sure you're twisting tight. Bunch of times so that nothing comes down.
I'm having a hard time getting it into it. There we go.
Sorry, I'm kind of all over the place on this video. I'm aware of that. Ooh, you know what? That's got to go up a little bit. It's got to go a little bit higher. I want that bow to be like, there we go.
Okay, so let's stand back here and start looking. It's kind of hard to get everything in frame, but I do like how it's coming together in theory here. So let me get the other bow on, the other one. There's still this little spot. Let me show you. See right there, you can see the work. So that's where I'm just going to kind of like hide it with some berries, these little twisty berries. So let's see how that works. Now, another thing to think about this project, yes, you're going to be looking at it like straight on, but this lamppost, I don't know if it's like 8 feet. I have no idea. A lot of it, you're going to be looking up at it. Okay, so it's just something you're not going to really see up here. You're definitely going to be viewing it from below. Now, when I did the project with the box planters, if you got to see my last video,
are low. So you are definitely viewing that looking down at those. So it's just kind of something to think about. What is the viewing, the vantage point of your projects? Let's see if this goes around. Oh, this is so, everything's getting. Okay, let's see if that's, oh, I lost some berries. Starting to come together. Now, something you can do here is like kind of, even if you're making a teardrop, let's say for your swag, for your front door, you can kind of pull these apart a little bit and then it's going to look much wider. So I always say do as much tweaking that you're going to want to do on this down here. You're up on that ladder, just spend as little time as you can. Now, you're still going to want to do tweaking up there, but okay. So, something for me. Let's see here. Yeah. I'm losing some of those berries, but that's okay. My bows got a little. Got to fluff those bows a little bit back. A little smushed. Oh boy. Okay. So this is where we're at. I kind of feel like I want a little piece of greens to hang. I can still see a little bit of that wire. Okay, see, I like that a little bit better, so. Okay, I think I'm liking what I got here. The bows, I need to fix a little bit. Okay, so I figured it out. I'm just gonna clip the tails that are on the actual pieces themselves. And what I did is I just put two zip ties together. And then when I'm up there, put this around the necks of that. And then as I'm up there, I'll pull these until it gets tight right around the neck of the lamppost. Now on to the fun parts. So the first thing I did was I used a pipe cleaner and I temporarily just attached it to the light post. And then I went back down to grab the other piece, and then that's when I used the zip ties to cinch it all together. And as you can see in this clip of the video, I did spend a lot of time kind of fiddling with it, since again, this was the first time I've ever done this project.